51V function test in Siemens 7SD82 relay. The 51V function is capable of detecting short circuit in the power grid. This function can be used in special network conditions where the overcurrent pickup limit can be changed depending on the fault voltage. In Siemens 7SD82 relay, this function can be used in function groups with three-phase voltage and current, and two inverse time stages depending on voltage and constant time with a specific undervoltage conditions are considered by default. In this test, the first stage of both categories is used. Note that in the 51V function test, the fault detection or non-detection is done according to the voltage and the current level of the test, which is voltage controlled and voltage restrained, used as a generated differential protection support and in power system to coordinate high current relays. In this test, as it is shown, the characteristic curve is voltage restrained. In the V over V rated range between 0.25 and 1, the diagram is linear, which the pickup current value is directly proportional to the voltage increase. In this regard, voltage is the phase-to-phase voltage measured, V rated, rated voltage, PU set setting of pickup threshold and PU pickup threshold applied, according to voltage. The control voltage for each current phase is according to the table. The setting in the 7SD82 relay for this protection stage are performed according to the image. If harmonics is to be included in the measurements related to this stage, select RMS value option in the method of measurement section. Otherwise, in order to skip harmonics and transient conditions, select fundamental COM, which is Siemens' suggested option. The 1.5 ampere current setting value is also a good option for most applications. The current threshold parameter for lines is up to 10%, and for transformers and engines up to about 20% higher than the maximum of the expected load adjusted. In the characteristic section, select the curve according to the IEC and ANSI standards. Here, the 1 ampere setting is used. To reset parameter, you can also select the instant reset option or reset by modeling the movement of desk relays. The time dial option also allows moving the characteristic in the direction of the time axis. The next stage in considering the undervoltage function conditions is also set as follow, so that if there are sufficient voltage conditions, the activation of the function is seen. After applying the settings on the relay and specifying the required contacts in the configuration section, it is time to test the function. Keep in mind that due to the curve performance, either use the pickup contact or consider the time required in the max fault time section for the 51V function performance. In the AMTVI starting room, to test the relay, first enter its information in the test object window. In a device block, information such as the relay's name, serial number, relay operation location, CT and PT specifications are entered. Also, to enter the setting of this function, you need to double-click on the VI starting block from the tree chart. And in the VI starting parameters page, enter the settings needed to display in the VI starting characteristic curve. In the tolerances section, you can also enter the percentage of acceptable fault to perform the test. By confirming the entered settings, it is time to perform shot test, check test, and search test. In the shot test tab, select the type of fault and points to test, and after the test is performed, the evaluation results can be seen. In check test, the upper and lower tolerances of the relay displayed as dashes in the VI starting characteristic are tested and evaluated. Note that the plotted check line should cross at least one of the tolerance lines of the characteristic curve. Search test is the last test performed on the VI starting characteristic curve. The purpose of this test is to find the characteristic curve line. The search line method is the same as check line. By performing the test, the software tests several points on the search line. Interpolating the characteristic curve and determining the exact location of the characteristic curve. Keep in mind that due to the required voltage level, by referring to the test object parameters and then the device block, the final voltage limit, or Vmax, may be increased. When the test ends and saves the file, simply select parameters to open the report setting window to get the result as an output file by selecting the parameters that need to be entered in the final report.